He's Froling and Peatling, two men we spoke about in the pre-game, and first jump is a little bit short. Now Landau wants to push to Peatling at the other end. Just little oopsie over the little shoulders, able to kiss it off the window. Golden Curls around in a handoff. McDaniel turned down one he just missed. Gets a little better shot, spins away and gets it to fall. And had a great rookie year last year, Sam Froling. Had some injuries as well that slowed him down, but he's played the end of the year was great. Landau at the other end, he's able to rattle it down. And they're firing on all cylinders early, United. Two or three from the three-point line, five or six overall. That's the six-point lead. He's on the points for the on the board for the first time. Right. Froling just dumps it to Ogilvy for the two-hand throw.
Alan Peatling on guys like Tyler Harvey and Justinian Jessup.
No matter where it is, that thing is going up.
And repeat that advice for the next time to Melbourne, get the ball and CG gets it. It's Tyler Harvey. One of six from the three-point line, 9 of 10 from the field. At the other end, Deng absolutely erased by Landau. And that is Sherelle Macken, the whole family back from Melbourne United. Chris Golding's their favourite player, and they're loving Jock Landale as well. Head to the NBL website to enter for your chance to win a $50 gift card, all thanks to Kmart. That is a gorgeous move by the big man. Spins into the middle, little finger roll this time. He's got eight. Never an issue with this depth at Melbourne United, Liam Santa Maria.
No, for sure. Especially when they can get wherever they want. And meanwhile, Jessup heating up down the other end.
So it is tough, and I liked in the Perth game, he got it in the post, made a couple of really good decisions. They went away from it once he has success. And I'm with you, Liam. Once he does something positive, that's going to count for Tyler Harvey.
Shay Ely wants a little one-on-one with Ding Ding. Shot clock's at five. Step back. Got it. This hot night continues. 8 of 12 from the three-point line.
An overzealous closeout. In the end, the Wild Childers benefited. And here we go, Justin Simon. A little bit of momentum.
And able to finish right on the halftime in the best possible way with the throwdown after the steal of Shay Ely.
Yeah, well, I mean, they shot a lot of threes. They shot a lot of threes. And we do need to get more physical.
Glad that Jessup knocked that down. It looked like Ogilvy had a pretty open layup. And Sam McDaniel continues his good little purple patch. Well, this is that small ball lineup right now. Brian Gorgie threw out there a couple of games ago against the Phoenix in the last quarter, got the job done, and dropped Landau. To go at, you'd think offensively, but defensively is going to be the issue.
Harvey, it's 1-on-3.
Well, now they're super small, the Hawks. Harvey with the floater, kisses that off the glass. They're going to be comfortable letting him shoot that. Is that Melbourne's bigs are versatile, agile. You see it right there from Landale as he spins his way to the rim. And Gorgian will be loving it. You know, they haven't got to stop every single time down the floor. Jessup tries to find Froling, the turnover results.
And Barber all the way and one. McCarron. Guarded by Nart, shot clock is off. Little spin on him, can he kiss it off the window? Yes, he can. Nonchalantly jogs the other way and jogs into a three-quarter time huddle.
But weren't able to make enough shots. Tyler Harvey, that's the man they need to get going as Hobson finds Luala Chul. The scramble from the Hawks wins the ball.
And now he wants to go a little one-on-one with Froling. Hobson has a three from there already. Make that two.
Well, he's just working into it. You're exactly right. He's only had the five field goal attempts. He's 3 of 5, just really taking it easy. Oh, my.
Froling, ding, ding, throw down. Simon will look at him. This is what happens in basketball nowadays. We don't play the final of it. And they've now won 8 in a row, have Melbourne United.